Welcome to another video from Dr. Locke. In this video we're going to show you how to make a jam key. So basically the key can go into the lock and it's going to jam and stay in the lock. It can be removed, but only without a great deal of difficulty, but can't be removed from the front. So this is how to create a jam key. Now we have a key that matches this cylinder. Here's our key right here, you can see. Here's our cylinder. Here's our pins, they're all pinned up. I'm just going to slide it back into the lock. There's our lock. Turns nicely. I can get the key out. I don't have the tailpiece on the back. That's why I have to hold it. If I was to pull it while it's turned, all the springs and pins would go everywhere. So in the point of this video is how to make a jam key. Now there's a couple of different ways that you can do it. First one is you could want to make a jam key so that it works like a turn snip. So you put the key in and it can never come out, but you could turn it at any time. So this would work if you've got a double-sided deadlock and you really want to operate like a single-sided, where you could walk up and just turn the key at any time. Be careful when doing that because some locks are not compatible with that. If you have a lock that's got a key on the inside and turns, you might not be able to operate it from the outside. But for the point of this video, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to basically get the key to go in and be stuck there. Now to start off with, you might be able to see this key here. I'll have to go right down here. Okay, you've got a fair idea there. Now you can see that all of these valleys here, they go down, they come up, they go down, they come up, and it's like a skiing slope. So skiing slope down to the valley and then you come back up again. To make a jam key, what you need to do is create an edge on one of these back edges here, not the front edge, because the pins have to go over the top to their seated position. And then when you try and pull the key out, you want it to get jammed right on this back edge right here, so that the pins can't go back up the ramp to allow you to get the key out. So this is only very rarely good. You wouldn't do this very often, but you might do it if you want the key to be stuck in the lock. And to get the key out, you actually have to dismantle the lock. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a straight edge, and then I'm going to show you the key. So I'm just going to give it a quick file. Then I'm going to show you how I'm going to get it out. Now I've done one, but to give it more holding power, I'm going to do another one. You don't want to remove any meat from the valley. You only want to take away the downward slope. This downward slope, you want to change it to a vertical so the pins get trapped. Okay, so I've done that now. I'm going to just let you zoom in. Hopefully you can see that a little bit clearer there. Okay, so this valley here is fine. This one here, I've created a straight edge here, so that's definitely going to jam. And I've created a bit of a straight edge here, so that's good enough for this demonstration. Now I don't have the tail on the back here, but it's not going to matter because I'm not going to be able to get the key out. So I put the key into the cylinder. It still turns. The reason it still turns is because I didn't take any meat off the valley, which is where the pins stay. Now I go to get my key out. I'm sorry, I should have put the circlip on. I go to get my key out and I'm completely trapped in there. I cannot get that key out. So the only way to get this key out now is to actually get to the back of the lock, remove this cylinder, get it in your hand like so, and from which we then would need to rotate it, use the follower, push it out, then tip the pins out. We can remove the key. So what is actually happening is these particular pins are getting stuck behind this edge right here. So this is a good point to note if you're ever cutting a key, to make sure that your valleys to get the key in, your ramps to get the key in are all on this nice angle, and to get the key out, they're all on this nice backwards angle. As long as you have that, the key will go in and out nicely, as long as there's no problem with the lock, such as spacing or loose circlip on the back. So that's how you make a trap key, simply by putting a straight edge on the back here, just like this. So if you really wanted to annoy somebody, you could, simply by getting a file and putting that edge on a key, letting them go and put it in the lock, and then you're pretty much out of luck. So that's how you create a trap key. Thanks for watching.